Friends, today we will see the subject advanced grammar, and in that the topic is uses of tenses. There are three major tenses: past tense, present tense and future tense. In these three major tenses there are four sub tenses in each of them. Likewise, simple past tense, simple present tense, simple future tense, continuous past tense, continuous present tense and continuous future tense, perfect past tense, perfect present tense and perfect future tense, perfect continuous past tense, perfect continuous present tense and perfect continuous future tense. So in all there are total 12 tense forms of three major tenses. Let us see the first form of the tense, that is simple present tense. Let us take an example. I go to school. When we say I go to school, it means I go to school every day. This tense is used for everyday activities, and the formula for this tense is subject, that is I, verb, that is go, and object, to school. In this tense, for third person singular, we need to add s or es as necessary. For example, she goes to school, wherein we have added es with verb go. The second example, he bats well, herein we have added s with the verb bat. Let us go to the next tense form, that is continuous present tense. Let us take an example. I am going to school. When we say I am going to school, we clearly mean I am just now going to school. That means the action is still continued. This tense is used for the action which is still continued at present. The action is not complete or not over. The formula for this tense is subject plus helping verb of present tense, that is am or is or are, plus verb, here in this case go, plus ing, plus object, here in this case it is to school. Let us go to the third tense form, perfect present tense. Let us take an example. I have gone to school. This tense is used for the action that has just been completed. The action is now over, but no much time has passed. It is just recently over. The formula for this tense is subject plus helping verb of present perfect tense, has or have, plus past participle of verb, in this case gone. Go is the original verb, went is the past tense of go, and gone is the past participle of verb go, plus object, in this case it is to school. Let us take the fourth one, perfect continuous present tense. Let's take an example. I have been going to school. Here this tense is used to show that the action was in continuation in everyday activity in past. The formula for this tense is subject plus helping verb of present perfect tense, has or have, plus been, plus verb, plus ing, plus object. Please remember, been and ing, they are added as the tense is continued, or tense was continued in recent past. Please note that this tense is used very rarely. Let us go to the fifth form of tense, that is simple past tense. The example is, I went to school. When I say I went to school, that means I went to school yesterday. This tense is used to show the action is already over in recent past. The formula of this tense is subject plus past tense of verb plus object. Here, past tense of verb is went, that is the past tense of go. Subject is I and object is to school. Let us go to the sixth form of the tense, continuous past tense. The example is, I was going to school. This tense is used to show that the action was in continuation in past. The formula for this tense is subject plus helping verb of past tense, that is was or were, plus verb plus ing plus object. Here the original form of verb is go, which is used, and ing is also applied to the verb. Remember, in every continuous tense, ing is must. Without ing to verb, continuous tense is never possible. Let us go to the seventh form of tense, that is perfect past tense. The example is, I had gone to school. Remember, this tense is used to show that the action was already over in past. The formula for this tense is subject plus helping verb of past perfect tense, that is had, plus past participle of verb, in this case gone, go, went, gone, plus object. Here the subject is I, had is the helping verb of past perfect tense, gone past participle of verb, and object is to school. Let us go to the eighth form, perfect continuous past tense. Example, I had been going to school. The tense is used to show that the action was in continuation at the time of happening, even though it is now already over. The action is over, but when we are talking of the action, the event, the action was going on. The formula for this tense is subject plus helping verb of past perfect tense, that is had, plus been, plus verb, in this case go, plus ing, plus object, that is to school. Remember, this tense is also used very rarely. Now let us go to the ninth form, simple future tense. Example, I will or shall go to school. We can use will or we can use shall. We can say I will go to school or I shall go to school. This tense is used to show that the action will take place in future. The formula for this tense is subject, that is I, plus helping verb of future tense, that is will or shall, plus verb, that is go, plus object, that is to school. Let us go to the tenth form, that is continuous future tense. The example is, I will be going to school or I shall be going to school. This tense is used to show that the action will be in continuation in future. The formula for this tense is subject plus helping verb of future tense, that is will or shall, plus be, plus verb, that is go, plus ing, plus object, to school. Remember, be and ing are added in the sentence structure while forming continuous future tense. Friends, let us see few more tenses. First is perfect future tense. The example is I would have gone to school or I should have gone to school. This tense is used to show that the action would have been completed if, maybe in future. The formula for this tense is subject plus helping verb of future tense, that is will or shall or would or should or may or might or can or could, etc. plus helping verb of perfect future tense, that is have, plus past participle of verb, in this case gone, go, went, gone, plus object. If we see subject, in this case it is I, helping verb of future tense used here is would or should, helping verb of perfect future tense is have, past participle of verb is gone, and object is to school. Let us go to the next one, perfect continuous future tense. I would have been going to school. This tense is used to show that the action may be over in continuation in future. The formula for this tense is subject, in this case I, plus helping verb of future tense, that is maybe will or shall or would or should or can or could or may or might, etc. In this case we have used would, plus helping verb of perfect future tense, that is have, plus been, plus verb go, plus ing, plus object to school. Remember, this tense is also used very rarely. Now let us see the helping verbs or supporting verbs. Helping verbs or supporting verbs are helping us in preparing better sentence structure with perfect meaning. Herein we will see which are the helping verbs or supporting verbs we use. For present tense, we use am or is or are, wherein am and is are used for singulars and are is used for plurals. In past tense, we use was or were. Was is used for singulars, were is used for plurals. In future tense, that is will or shall or would or should or may or must or might or can or could, either of these can be used. In present perfect tense, we use have or has. In past perfect tense, we use had. And in future perfect tense, we use have. Remember, for perfect tense, we have different supporting verbs for perfect present tense, perfect past tense, and perfect future tense. Now let us see some important rules about the tenses, different tense forms. Remember, in every simple tense, no helping verb is used except in simple future tense, wherein we use will or shall. In every continuous tense, verb plus ing is must. Without ing, without verb plus ing, continuous tense is not possible. In every perfect tense, helping verb of perfect tense, that is according to the major tense, is must. In every perfect continuous tense, been and verb plus ing is must. Remember, these four rules are important to prepare any sentence in respective tenses. Thank you very much for listening me. If you have any question, please revert back. Thank you.